Hey everyone, this is Ryan with IBM. Excited you came by the IBM Technology Channel today. We're gonna be talking about what is data observability, one of the hottest topics in the data space today. But before we get there, I just wanna remind you, please subscribe, like the channel, interact with us in the comments. This really helps us produce the videos you wanna see from us in the future. So go ahead, like it, share it, say it to your mom and dad. You know, let's get the word out there. All right, so before we get into data observability, I want to tease you a little bit. And I'm going to use a train analogy later on in this demonstration. So what I want you to do is, if you are really excited about trains like I am, I love trains. I used to play with trains all the time during Christmas time with my grandpa growing up. This is going to be a cool example to show you how we're connecting everything together with data pipelines, data engineering, and also observability. So we're going to get back to that, I promise. Okay, so let's give a little quick history lesson of what's going on in the industry and how we're getting to this data observability moment that we're seeing right now. And it really comes down to something going on that is compared to the software engineering group and explosion that's happened in the last, you know, 5 to 8 years, which is software engineers are basically ruling the world. These developers are ruling with frameworks and methodologies like CI and CD. They're pioneering things like DevOps. They're doing things like infra as code, all these really advanced things in the software development space. It's really blown up. And these are all like table stakes nowadays. If you're a software engineer, you're basically doing all of these things. And you're doing that with building applications like building applications in the cloud. You're building microservices. And you're also building applications. So all these things are great. And recently, around 5 years ago, there was a blow up in the space around observability itself. There's another video that we've done at IBM around observability. I encourage you to check that out. And it's really around this idea of application performance monitoring, or APM. APM is really around being able to detect problems and performance issues in your application so developers can be alerted right away and go resolve something. Whether a server was down or you had an application hiccup in production, you know right away through the trace logs and issues that they know exactly where to go to fix that, right? And that's awesome that they've got all these tools kind of helping them out. Well, what's going on now is that it used to be that, you know, everyone was a software company. Every company is now a software company. Well, now every company is now a data company. And what's going on is that a lot of these software engineering folks or developers or engineers, they're actually moving to become data engineers. And so they're using a lot of the same skill sets. They're, you know, code heavy skill sets like Python and using frameworks like DevOps, all these things that they're used to as software engineers, and now becoming data engineers to take the same things we're doing around continuous delivery for application development now into data development within the organization today. So where software engineers really care about the applications that they're building, like cloud, microservices, and applications out there, what data engineers are actually really focused on is their data pipelines. These data pipelines are the things that are moving the data from the source all the way to the end state of the consumer. And they're in charge of around 80 to 90% of all the data flow within their organization today. But the problem is this, is that whereas software engineers have APM, application performance monitoring, as an observability tool to help them find things right away, alert them, resolve them, data engineering really isn't there yet. And this is where observability comes into play. Observability is basically, data observability is the next step for data engineers to operationalize any incident detection that they have within their data pipelines. So let's walk through, and we're gonna use the train analogy as a pipeline. So view this train as an actual pipeline that's gonna be moving down the tracks here. But this is what data engineers will do. They are building pipelines or orchestrating the data from their source data all the way to their end consumer. And these could have hundreds to thousands of different data pipelines that they're using. Most commonly, they're using open source tools like Apache Airflow to take the data and move it. And just to illustrate real quick, this becomes a complicated problem because what you're doing is you're taking all different types of sources that you can maybe can and cannot control from third-party applications, from web server APIs, things like that. You're taking these things, and then we're expected to funnel them into storage areas like a data warehouse or something that's unstructured like a data lake. So data engineers, again, they're in charge of moving this data to eventually, when you get the data in the right state, they want to be able to power the data products that you're building today. And those could be things like business analytics, finance, marketing, sales, having predictive analytics around, the success of their business and making decisions off of that data. That's one use case. Another use case is actually just building data products themselves, applications that are mobile or web or have high volume of transactions that are associated with those, like, for example, like a sports betting company. That would be an example of building a data product. ML deep learning pipelines is another one. Using these pipelines to really drive and take the business to the next step in their AI journey for trustworthy data. So all this at the end of the goal, though, what they're really trying to do is they're trying to deliver the data in a trustworthy way to eventually get to their consumers. Now, this would be great if everything works well in these pipelines, right? But I hate to break it to you, but that's not how things work. We also know that data engineers are spending around 50% of their time actually maintaining these pipelines because things break and things are constantly halting them from building these really cool data-driven products in their organization today. So where does observability come in? Well, it all goes back to being able to monitor and observe your data pipeline. So let's walk through the examples of this, the problems that these data engineers, these teams will face with this train analogy that I wrote up here. So the first one is this. If you're on a train and you're sitting there waiting for it to move, the first thing you're going to ask is the train moving or not? You want to be able to understand right away, hey, is the train moving? And that relates back to a pipeline. Is the pipeline actually operational? Is the pipeline executing or is it failing or is it halted? Is it stalled? If the data pipeline is not moving correctly, if it's not moving at all, this data cannot get to the end consumer. The next question is like, well, how fast is this train going? Is it going at 90%, 80%, 20%? Did it take an hour when it should have taken 5 minutes? Did it take 10 hours when it should have taken 1 hour? This is a problem if we don't understand if we don't know exactly when the data is going to be first operationalized and running in orchestration with the pipelines. But also, if we have a data SLA that needs to get there at a certain time, well, we got to know that. We got to know that that's gonna be a problem, right? So that's the first part. The second part is around the cargo on the train. So all trains, hopefully you're taking cargo. Maybe they got cars, maybe they got computers, whatever it is. Well, the next question is, okay, if our pipeline's running really good, well, what's going on with the actual data sets? That's basically the cargo on that pipeline. This is what gets into understanding if there's anything going on with the data at the data set level. So for example, there could have been a schema change to this that we had no idea about. So we were expecting 10 columns and we got 11. We're expecting 10 columns and we got 9. That's a problem because that data is going to be impacted downstream with something that's going to consume that data set. We also could have sent a null record through. Let's say it was a really high value piece of data that we expected to come through every single day and didn't happen. That's a problem. Or if the data actually changed, if all these are checks and one's an X, that's a problem. It's going to corrupt the data downstream with the data we're moving in these data pipelines. So the first one is really around the process quality. The second one is around the data quality within the actual pipeline. And the next one is around the lineage. So if you are on a train, the train is going to go somewhere eventually. It's going to drop off the cargo. It's going to go on different tracks. It may hook up. Change trains may go to, if you're going from Georgia to New York City, maybe you need to stop in Delaware as an example. This really gets into data lineage, which is how are things connected to dependent pipelines and data sets downstream. So for example, if we know the pipeline is working good, but then we find that there's a problem in the actual data with the pipeline. The next question is, how does this problem here impact something downstream of another data set that's consuming from another pipeline? So we want to know right away, if this fails, we don't be able to know that it's going to impact this person down here to let them know. And this is what data observability is all about. What we're doing is we're operationalizing the incident detection. So whenever we see a problem at the source, the warehouse, even downstream at the product level, we want to be able to alert up into the data engineering team so they can be notified right away when a problem occurs. They can fix it and prevent it from getting from impacting downstream consumers and ultimately having big costly impacts to the business. And so really the tenets of data observability is to detect earlier, get those detections right away at the source, resolve them faster, know exactly where they are and how they affect other people downstream, and then ultimately deliver that trustworthy data to hit your expected data SLAs for your end consumers. So to wrap it up, talked a little bit about the industry of what's going on. A lot of software engineers moving to data engineering. They need the tools to help them be able to operationalize any incidents that occur within their data pipelines. We gave a simplistic example of a very complex workflow that data engineers are constantly dealing with, which is pumping source data all the way to their end consumers and dealing with tons of different tools in between that could prevent a bad issue or a dirty data problem downstream to the consumers. And we also had a little fun talking about how this connects into a train analogy. So I really hope you enjoyed this video about what is data observability, and check back for the channel for more videos in the future. Thanks everyone. If you like this video and want to see more like it, please like and subscribe. If you have any questions, please drop them in the comments below.